going, everybody? So something that I wanted to talk about a little bit for a couple of reasons. One, it's something that kind of affects a lot of us in the YouTube movie reviewing community. And secondly, because Guns Akimbo is coming out later this week, I want to clear up a whole bunch of stuff rather than getting into it in my actual review, because otherwise I'm going to spend several minutes before actually getting into the movie waffling on about a whole bunch of political stuff that's going on at the moment. So I just wanted to make a separate video just to address this whole thing. So the director of Guns Akimbo, which is a movie that I've been really looking forward to. I mean, the trailers look absolutely amazing. They got the whole, you know, film world buzzing. Like, a lot of people were excited for this film. And then as of yesterday or the day before, it was brought to light that the director, Jason Lee Howden, is pretty much a scumbag. I'm not going to get too deep into what he's done, but basically he's been going on Twitter, going online and just harassing people unfairly. Like I said, this whole thing goes a lot deeper. It involves other people in the film community, in the blog community, racism, a whole bunch of things. Just Google it if you want. You'll get the whole story pretty easily. Yeah, it turns out this guy, he's not a very nice man, and he's still continuing to go on and harass people as well, which just blows my mind. I mean, you got a movie coming out, a really big movie, and you're doing this to tarnish your name? Because there's a lot of YouTubers now, and film critics, and, you know, people in that sort of community who are basically boycotting doing reviews of the film. Well, some people are outright boycotting even seeing the film. And look, I get that. It's a show of support for the victims of this guy's harassment. It is showing that we're standing by these people. It's definitely a good thing, and I do understand it. Now, I bought tickets to this movie last week before, I can't remember. So yeah, I'm still gonna go and see it, and I'm still gonna review it. Like I said, I totally get why people wouldn't do it, and I don't want to change anybody's mind at all. But the reasons why I still want to review it, there's a few reasons. One, it's not just the director who worked on the film. I mean, yeah, he's the sole, the chief creative person who worked on it. There's no doubt about that. But you know how when you watch a movie and at the end there's like hundreds of names that come up? All of those people contributed to the film. And I recently had an encounter with somebody who messaged me out of the blue on social media because she had worked on The Invisible Man. She was an effects artist from a small company who worked on it, and she had asked me really politely if I could get a photo of her name in the end credits, because she wasn't going to get to see the film for a while and she wanted to send the photo of her name to her family. And I thought that was really sweet, and so yeah, I thought okay. And so I was waiting for the credits to roll, waiting for her name to come up, and it never did. And it kind of got me thinking, like, you know, if someone worked on a film in any sort of capacity, shouldn't they be credited? It's, you know, I have this thing that I say to people that, you know, every cog in this machine that is the production of a film, every tiny little piece all contributes to making it all work. And I didn't really agree with her name not being there. She was on IMDb, but still, I don't know. I thought that was a bit weird. But the fact that she was so proud of her work, whatever her contribution was, you know, it really spoke volumes to me. And I'm sure it's the same with this film. There's probably going to be a ton of people who contributed in some way or other, who are really proud of what they've done, who are really looking forward to people seeing the film and celebrating it despite what the director has done. And so I'm kind of inclined to support those people. You know, even though, yeah, I don't agree with what the director's done, but I'm sure there's ways to review the film without even mentioning him or, you know, anything like that. And secondly, you know, we've got this whole thing, like, I hate using trend words like cancel, but, you know, if we're going to be canceling this guy, you know, along, you think about the history of filmmakers and stuff who have been horrible people. People like Harvey Weinstein and Victor Salva, who did Jeepers Creepers, and even John Lasseter. Like, there's a whole bunch of people that you know, we still watch their films. We, like, John Lasseter directed Toy Story 1 and 2. You know, if we're going to start cancelling people and boycotting their films and everything, like, we should probably think about, well, all right, that's it. I'm going to burn my Toy Story Blu-rays or DVDs or whatever. So, yeah, if we're going to take it this far with Guns Akimbo, it's a little hypocritical if we're not going back. And, I mean, Harvey Weinstein, I think on IMDb, has something like 325 producing credits. And these include nearly all of Quentin Tarantino's films, the Lord of the Rings trilogy. You know, this guy has had his hand in a lot of films, a lot of our most favorite films. So if we're going to be boycotting Guns Akimbo and anything that Jason Lee Howden has done, then we've kind of got to go and do that as well. Like, you know, we can't just sort of single out one person and only focus on what he's done. Like, yeah, it's a much bigger picture, you know. So anyway, those are my thoughts on this whole matter. Like I said, I'm not trying to change anyone's mind. If you're boycotting this film, if you're boycotting doing a review of it, that is absolutely fine. I probably just wanted to address why I'm still going to be reviewing this film. I mean, like I said, I'm probably not going to mention the guy's name. I'll be perfectly happy to do that. And at least at the start of it now, I can just say, hey, there's a whole bunch of stuff, but I've done it in another video. Go watch that. Now onto the film, rather than spilling all of this out at the start of it. So, yeah, anyway, that's pretty much all I wanted to say about the whole matter. Yeah, so thanks for watching, and yeah, start a conversation down below. Let me know what your thoughts are on it. I know there's a few people who aren't aware of this whole situation, so yeah, hopefully maybe it's opened some people's eyes to what's going on. I don't know. And yeah, look, if you're still seeing Guns Akimbo, then yeah, good on you. Like I said, everything's up to you guys what you want to do. I'm not changing anyone's mind. So yeah, anyway, stay tuned. I guess my next review probably will be Guns Akimbo. So yeah, thank you for taking the time to watch this video and listen to my little rambling here, and I'll see you when that review comes up.
Click subscribe to stay up to date with all the latest movie reviews. Skynet will be taking over any day now, so what have you got to lose? Nyah!